Okay, so everyone open it. I hope you already opened the software that I so I'll start to share content. Okay, so you can see the CS software already open. So if you anyone yang is already open the software, you should choose level 2 macam what is starting from the from the sheet. Okay, so I'll be referring to lab sheet 1 okay today. Okay, so I'll be showing so what we're doing today. Okay, I'll be referring to this lab sheet. Okay, and do accordingly to CS Repack. Okay, I think anyone yang group 2 should done, I think, 2 lab session excuse me, with Dr. Zul. Dr. Zul, so yeah, I think it's some anyone yang group 1 pun yang dah join pun, you should be familiar dah lah, done with the software. If anyone who did join with Dr. Zul. Okay, so basically, this is actually if you let me show you. If you once you open the software, okay, the view is a bit different lah. You have to choose. Let me show. Okay. You actually this is the view that you see earlier on. Okay, early on when you open the software first time. Okay, or maybe every time you run the software, so you should choose level 2 normally. Okay, for this session, a specific session, we'll choose level 2. Okay, okay, so that's the interface. Okay, and then what's this? So over here. Okay, over here you see this is the browse section. Okay, from here the table was you can choose the material universe or process this produce material universe, which is the database for all the materials that available in the software. Okay, for process universe, then you have joining, shipping. This is all the process that available in the database. Producers, some of the known producers, if you click here, you'll find information on ceramic producers. If you click here on composite, you see the composite producers, fibers, and so on and so forth. And then references, and this is what are the information that is being used to develop the database in the software. Okay. So this is the main interface that you should be looking. Okay, and then to browsing database. Okay, we continue on the step 3 in the lab sheet. Okay, so you should just click on browse and then select table here, and then you can just open as I shown you just now. You can just browse here. If you click, then all the information, for example, like technical ceramics, you have alumina, aluminium nitride, and everything. And for metals, you have ferrous, and then non-ferrous. So all these are the information that, again, there, as I mentioned, I think in our, when our session, okay, I can't remember, I think the second session. This is the 2013 software, so we only have the information up until, I think, around 2012. So what between, it's already about 8 years for today, so there is a lot of information changes, for example, added, but probably so some of this information is not available here if you by default install the software, but I mean, unless you have the newer version. Okay, but actually we can actually add, but in this I won't show it now. Maybe down in the later session, our lab session, then maybe I can show you what we can do with the database. Okay, so here, so I ask you to choose any, for example, if I choose one record, for example, for metal composites here. So if I click here, then if I double click, and then I can find all the information is available. Okay, you can see what is the description, what is the composite. If you click on the composite summary here, then you find a note here saying that what the chemical makeup. Okay, what is the definition? Okay, and then you have an image, an example about the aluminium silicon carbide composite here for break disc. Okay, and then you have all the information of the material, the general properties, date, first use, estimately about 1982 and everything. And then apart from this also, you can also try for using search function over here. So let's say we want to try and find, wood, for example. So if I here, so you have anything information that is related to wood. Okay, so you have material universe. These are the material process. What are the process that wood can that you can apply to a material? For example, wood, the producer's information, also the references that is being used to develop in the database. Okay, so for this, you just for example, if you refer to our lab sheet, so it asks you to first choose any record name. For example, I did just now for silicon carbide, so just here. So if you want to screenshot, if you're using Microsoft Windows, you can use the key, Windows key, Shift and S. Okay, then just highlight. If you don't want to highlight all, just scan the window, which is the snipping tool. If you have that is the shortcut key. If not, you can just search in the Windows in your menu and find snipping tool. For me, I just use the shortcut key Windows key Shift and S, and then I just choose this part. I don't have to choose all the information. So I just choose that, and then I'll paste in the result table, which is result one. Okay, I'm moving here. So see, just now I screenshot. You can use the screenshot key or whatever, and then you have to paste it in another software, for example, Paint. Recut it. So if I just use the snipping tool, I just choose the area that I want you to screenshot. Okay, so just paste, and then you get the first result. And then next, it says here that find any text. So just now I choose for wood. Search here for wood. And I choose any kind, for example, this one. Okay, it says here. Search any text. So, and then I just find it like this. So you just, again, snipping tool, and then screenshot. So it's basically simple finding information. Okay, because this our first step is actually trying to familiarize you with what are the functions that are available in CS Repack. Excuse me. So this is what are the the advice that when you want to find search, because again, you can try to find, if I put here, for example, just a generic word, can somebody maybe give an example, one material that you want to search, for example? Anyone give an example? Any kind of word that you want me to search? Sama-sama boleh bagi ni, satu material ke ataupun satu proses ke, anything? Baik, siapa boleh anyone can input to me? Tak ada siapa ke semua ni, there is no one in front of the PC now?
Fiber.
Fiber, okay, let's say for example if we type fiber. So you have 25 results in material universe. You have 20 processes that could be involved with fiber. What are 37 producers and what are the references? So if you choose for example these are the reference that the developer of the software used to create the database of information of fiber in the CSRD pack. Okay, so that is the example. Okay, all right, next, obtaining key browse. So I want you to find for stainless steel record and then concrete and PP. So you can, this is, you can do it by yourself. Okay, and just copy and paste. Okay, actually for lab one, actually I want you don't have to submit. Okay, because if you look in our ULearn for today's session, I only put submission for lab two, because for lab, this first lab session is only to familiarize you with the function, finding information and everything in the software. Okay, and anyone can boleh faham situ, anyone can basically understand that. Okay. So far any questions? Ada soal, ada any questions? Ada soalan ke?
Tak ada, sir. Cuma tak ada, sir. Tak ada.
Apa? Kali? Okay, apa dia? Any questions? Tak ada?
Tak ada.
Boleh, okay. Okay, so this is basically if you look at the lab sheet, trying to familiarize you with finding information and how to and what that information can be. For example, in obtaining, for example, this, if you look at, okay, if you look here, finding linking between process and the process and material. For example, if I choose, let's say PP here. Okay, so if I move down, okay, these are the general properties. You can look mechanical properties, thermal properties and everything. If I go further downwards, you have links here, references, process universe. And if I click specifically, for example, process universe here, so these are the process that PP can go, can be a process that involves PP. Excuse me. Okay. For example, if I click on joining, I choose adhesive. So what are the adhesives that PP can be, that can use for PP? Fasteners here. These are the processes that can use, for example, for shaping. What are the processes that can be used to shape polypropylene? Machining, conventional machining. These are the processes that can be used for PP. Okay, molding, thermoplastic molding, because polypropylene is a thermoplastic. Okay, and then for surface treatment, what are the processes for surface treatment that can be used on PP? These are how the information is linked together. Okay, if I and then I just, if I don't want, I go back to PP again, I just use, because you can just move the tab, you can just link, it's just, if you are, it's just using a Windows template. Okay, if I use if I click on producers, then I can, okay, click on composite. These are the producers. Okay, about PP, PP polymer, PP composites. These are the producers, and for just the polymer itself, these are some of the producers, or not necessarily the producers, meaning the industries that use PP in their products, or in the company. Okay, mean that not only these are just, not when they say producers, not necessarily mean that the companies that produce PP, but the companies that produce products that use PP. Okay, so those that actually we have is included together. Okay. Okay, any other questions? Soalan? Ada soalan ke? Any question? For now tak ada, sir. Alright, okay. Okay, good. Alright, so you can complete it by yourself, okay? Just help you to familiarize with the software and how to use, because you actually need to be familiar with software. Each individual of you have to have the software installed. And I'm sorry, I think I didn't mention early on, but this software is only available for Windows-based PC. So I think you can't use, I don't know if anyone, siapa yang, anyone yang pakai Mac ke apa ke, you can't use for Apple Mac OS installed. If you want to use, then you have to use a virtual machine on Mac to boot Windows, and then you can run CS Edupack. Okay, alright. So I think we can move on to lab 2. Is it okay? Boleh, kita pergi ke lab 2 eh. Okay, sir. Okay, so this is lab 2. Actually, I haven't covered some of the process in lab 2 in our lecture, so I'll be covering it tomorrow, insyaAllah. Okay, but this is how we used the information in lab 2, and how do we relate with using the software. Okay, so okay, for this lab 2, if you see here, okay, how we apply selection strategy, which is the design process, in applying in the software. Okay, for example, I use this is an example of a product, which is a visor for helmet. Okay, a motorcycle helmet, but a kind of visor for helmet. Okay, so essentially a material is required for the visor of a safety helmet. Okay, to provide maximum facial protection. Now, to allow clear vision, the visor must be optically transparent. Okay, and to protect the face from front, from sides, and from below, it must be doubly curved, meaning that it is curved on both sides, okay, to cover the front face and both sides of the head, and also below, so to cover also the chin, the on lower part of our head. And then fracture of the visor would expose the face to damage, maximizing safety, therefore translates into maximizing resistance to fracture. Okay, the material property that measures resistance to fracture is the fracture toughness, K1C. This is a material property, which is a fracture toughness. What K1C means is a property of a material to resist propagation of defect or crack. Okay, that is what K1C means. Okay, I think you've already taken material testing and fracture analysis, right? So belum, dah. I think last semester with Dr. Ridwan and Dr. Fauzi, yes? BMMP3573. You've already taken that subject last semester. Next semester you'll be taking that subject. Okay, so the definition of fracture toughness ni, kalau some of you still don't know, okay, the fracture toughness is the resistance of material to propagation of defect and crack. Okay, defect or crack, okay, that's the definition. So a material with very high fracture toughness, it doesn't fail easily with a material with lower fracture toughness. For example, this is an aluminium block. Okay, So normally metal have high fracture toughness as compared to this is a glass mug. Okay, so between these two material, this metal has higher fracture toughness as compared to a glass mug. Okay, you can, as anyone can see this. Okay, so what does it mean is that if I try to I'm interjecting with the material subject here. Okay, so if I try to pull or try to apply load, there's a, if you see here, there's sort of a drilled hole, a semi-hole, semicircle hole here. Okay, so if I try to pull it, okay, because of its higher fracture toughness, is it will be difficult for the material to start failure, crack, failure and fracture, and finally. But for example, for this glass mug, if I introduce a crack, a defect on the mug, if I pull it, it will be, what is fracture would be very sudden, brittle and catastrophic. Okay, and that's what it means with lower fracture toughness. Okay, so that's basically the definition. Okay, so that's why it says here, for example, the visor, okay, it must have the property is the fracture toughness. Okay, so that if it go through because the for example, a rider or user of a helmet that has a visor, then if it has lower fracture toughness, meaning that it could fail easily and devastatingly catastrophic, the failure, it will have more risk of injury to the user. If it has higher fracture toughness, then it will resist the failure, so that it risk a lower risk of injury to the user. Okay, so that is the requirement. Okay, for the helmet visor. Okay, so okay, sorry, okay, Mark. All right. Okay. So next, this is the this is what actually I will talk actually for tomorrow in the lecture session. Okay, how we what is the process that we translate when we are presented with information regarding a requirement, or you have information, so for example, that's been given like this. Okay, so what are the procedures or what is the process that we go through? First, we translate design requirements expressing the function, constraint, objective, and so the and also the three variables. And from then we screen using the concept, we eliminate materials that cannot do the job or that does not meet the requirement. And then we rank using objective, meaning that the materials with the higher possibility, with the higher the best can do the properties that you want, then we choose. And we find the information finally. This is actually I'll be talking with our lecture on what are the requirement, what is the process when we go through for selection strategy for materials. Okay, so based on the information presented in the paragraph inventory, fill in the translation table. Example for me, so you have to fill in information. This is an example, so you have to fill the information here. Okay, so function. Okay, so so anyone can tell me what is the function of this product here? Anyone can, just anyone say what is the function of this product, apa function yang kita nak? Siapa boleh jawab?
Protect head.
Okay, and lagi? Anything else? Ada lagi information? tengah. Who was saying that? I can't hear you. Who was saying that? Anyone else would you like to name? For lucky, I only heard from the boys. Okay, haven't heard any from the girls yet. Anyone? Siapa nak ni? Chan ke? Siapa di sini? Ke siapa? Pak Iza ke? Anyone? Siapa-siapa boleh ke? Semua tak ada depan komputer ni.
Reduce head injury.
Reduce head injury. Okay, good. Okay. Actually, the easiest part is actually for function, we just put in the name of the product. Okay, that is the easiest part lah. So, you put here, laser for helmet. Because that is the part kita, the information here is not the helmet. Eh? We just want to find information for the helmet visor. You can put here visor for helmet, or you can put here helmet visor. Just put in the product name or product the what we want from the what do we expect to have. Okay, the end product also we can put in. If you want, for example, if the information here is regarding, if you find information is regarding a shoe, for example, sport shoes, and you put here function sport shoes, for example. Okay. So the objective here. So what are the objectives? Okay, it's already been discussed here. Okay, the objective is to therefore, what is this? What does it say here? Anyone say and tell me what does it say?
Maximize fracture toughness.
Maximize fracture toughness of K1C. So you can put here maximize fracture toughness. Also can A1C. Okay, you can put in that, or you want to just maximize K1C, no problem. Okay, you can put that. So this is the objective. So what are the constraints? What would be the constraints for this okay, from the information here, what do you think? If you look at the paragraph, what are the constraints that is mentioned? It's already clearly mentioned here. What are the constraints?
Transparency and ability to be molded.
Yes. Excuse me. So these are the constraints. Transparency. So then, this is then finally the three variables. These are the information that you want. Meaning that between just in this information here that you get, that you can extract the free variables, meaning what are the areas or what are the how to say information that you can freely choose, or for example, or what are the freedom that you have. That's the word I was looking for, freedom on what are the areas that you have freedom, meaning that you don't have to worry. Okay, so if you see here, it says here that we want a material. Okay, so we don't really have the information that the objective, you have to maximize the fracture toughness or K1C. We have the constraint that there has to be transparent and it must be easy to be molded. Okay, so in this case, the free variables mean what are the freedom that we can we can have when we choose our material, would be the choice of material. Because it doesn't say here that it must be, let's say the material must be, it doesn't mention that it must be metal, ceramic, or polymer. Okay, although you have that perception that, because you already know that some of you already been experienced using a visor, using helmet with a visor, you already know that by experience that okay, the visor must be plastic, okay. But in this case, just for the discussion, okay, we leave it. We put here choice of material that we, for example, that we know that we assume that any kind of materials that meet that can have a maximum fracture toughness and have transparency and ability to be molded, we just put it there. Meaning that this is what we want, the feedback that we don't consider, our own, we put in our own prejudice of what experience that we have on what we've seen, the experience, life experience. So we put it aside first, and we just put in that any freedom of any choice of materials were open, okay. For this because kind of mindset, then it'll be easier for us to it'll be more beneficial to us to be open to all kind of choices and opportunities. Okay, faham eh? Maksud saya tu, I have to speak in Malay if some students can understand. Maksud saya tu, kenapa saya tak free variables ni, choice of materials, meaning that bila masuk free variables, maksudnya kita nak bebas nak pilih apa material. Sebab dalam teks ni, dia cuma kata kita nak pilih material yang perlu ada sekian-sekian requirement, okay. So dalam, walaupun kita tahu sebenarnya macam by daripada pengalaman kita tahu memang visor tu plastik, tapi kita just nak orang kata apa, supaya kita letak sini, nanti bila kita dapat result dalam kita punya software tu, kita akan supaya kita macam lebih macam terbuka lah, oh ada material ni juga, ada material ni juga, dan sekian. Okay, alright, moving on. So screening, so assess here, open CSIDFX software and choose level 2 database, choose select edu level 2, choose limit and optical quality and apply. Okay, so paste result in result 2. So I'll close here, I'll choose result. Okay, material universe, edu level 2. Okay, and then it says here, I have to choose limit optical quality and apply. So where is the limit? Okay, I choose here, this is I want to choose. Okay, select here, this I click on select, yeah. Because it says here, okay, when it opens, choose select editor 2, and then choose select, this is what it says, choose select here, okay. From browse here, I choose select here, then I select database selection data, I choose edu level 2. So these are the information that I have. We have about 100 materials that we can choose from. Okay, there's 100 materials for education level 2 material universe. If I change here, for example, with durability properties, okay, then with eco properties or durability, if I choose, for example, shaping joining, okay, these are the information, but these are the process, okay, so we want to choose material universe. So we choose material level 2, and then I click on limit here, and then optical properties. It says here optical properties. Okay, so I choose optical quality, not transparent. This is a bit different, but here. Click on optical quality and apply, meaning that it will rank material based on its optical quality. Okay, so materials that do not have any optical quality. What does it mean by optical quality? Is that meaning materials that have optical properties. For example, If you, if, let's say, because when you talk about optical properties, let's say, okay, I'll return back to this is again aluminium block. Okay, aluminium, usually metal have some form of optical property, meaning that it can reflect light. If you beam a torchlight on a metal surface, it can reflect that light. So some form of optical, and you can, but at the same time, it's also very opaque. It doesn't allow light to go through. Okay, so that is some properties. But if you have, for example, like this mark, you can actually have, you can't see it, but you have any kind of a transparent glass mark or anything, so it can give some, it can have light go through it, so you can see the other side of the material. Okay, we don't choose transparent because if we choose transparent, we want the material really transparent. Okay, that's why we don't choose transparent. If you choose transparent, meaning that you really want, but it does have to have some level of optical quality. That's why we don't choose transparent. If we choose translucent, meaning that the material that we want is actually allow some form of light to go through, but at the same time it doesn't allow. And if we choose opaque totally, then we don't want any kind of light to go through. So that's why we choose only some. We want to have some freedom, or some we have to open our choice. Okay, so if you put in, if I click here and then just click on apply, you see here apply from 100 and I just choose optical quality here, then I am left with just 7 out of 100, meaning that only these are materials that have optical quality that you get, that we require. If I choose just example transparent, okay, I only have this kind of polymer. Okay, these are materials that can be totally transparent. Okay, if I use choose opaque, for example, so these are materials that is opaque, that it doesn't allow light to go through. So that's why we don't choose, preferably we choose optical quality, because what it means by optical quality is that both it has to be transparent and also have some good for it, that all the qualities of the opaque, translucent and also transparent. So that's why we don't choose specifically transparent. Okay, all right, so so and apply, so paste the result in result 2. Okay, so we got already as I said the result. So what you do, you just again snipping tool, Windows key, Shift S. If you don't know how to find, you can just search in your Windows. So we just choose, so this side we want to screenshot, and then we open our is it very simple. Okay, and then next it says here, choosing limit again, choose mechanical properties, and at the maximum value put in 10 million Pascal fracture toughness, Pascal square root meter. Okay, this is the unit for fracture toughness. Okay, and apply. Meaning that we want to have a material that is very that is high. So okay, so if you see here, we already have stage 1 transparency, which is optical quality. We already have it. Okay, optical properties here, transparency, and then we choose again limit, then choose mechanical properties, and then we go to fracture toughness here, this one, fracture toughness, and it says here maximum value. Okay, meaning that we want to have at least, at maximum 10. You can put here 10 E7 like this. Okay, exponential. Okay, this is 10 million. Okay, 1E7 is 1 exponential 7, meaning that 1 at the power of 7. So if 10 million, it will be the same. Okay, that is how it works. Okay, so then click on apply. Okay, so we have stage 1, transparent. This meaning that the transparent has good optical quality. And then 2, we have the fracture toughness maximum must be 10 million megapascal square root meter. So again, we are still left with 7 materials here. So we just screenshot. So the result. So we move on. And we paste again. Okay, for the result. And then next, okay. Now, how do we? We translate the process, okay, from how to choose the material to that can do the requirements or the properties that we want. So we already translated. We already screened using the constraints, meaning that transparency. We want to have good optical quality. We want to have it's we haven't gone to it's remolded, but we already rank it with already know the fracture toughness that we want. So then we want to rank it. Okay. So how to rank it? Okay. So choose rank by as per above, choose stage 2 fracture toughness. Click on, okay, here it says here, click on fracture toughness, rank the material. So if I go to the software here, rank by, meaning here I choose rank by fracture toughness. Currently this is a UC, if you see here, the results here you can choose, you can show if you want to dive into more information. It shows the pass fail table, meaning that starting from we started with 100 information of materials that pass level 1 optical quality. So you see X meaning that these are materials that did not pass. And then and then for the second stage, which is the fracture toughness, okay, these are materials that passed. So only materials that pass both stages are considered. Okay, so that's why that is the culmination, okay, of all the material that passed. So we rank by, it says it to rank by fracture toughness. So you see here, this is the lowest fracture toughness, and these are that has the highest, meaning that it ranked from the lowest to the highest. Okay, here 0.5. If you click here, you can rank from highest to lowest. If you click here again, you get when you rank from lowest to highest fracture toughness. Okay, so you see here, these are the materials that has lower part of its fracture toughness, and these are the material that's the highest fracture toughness. Next, okay, paste the result on result 3. So you can, it doesn't matter if you want to rank it from highest to lowest or lowest to highest, it doesn't it's okay as long as you rank it correctly. Okay, so just screenshot the result that you got and then paste in the whole result sheet. So you already gone there. So next though, find information on all materials left either online or any source and place in the result box. So what you need to do is you need to find the information, okay, and then paste it in the result. Did I paste it correctly? Ayat 2. Ayat 3. Oh, I think I paste it incorrectly. Ayat 3. Yeah, this is going to be ayat 3. So here, you need to find information on all this, seven materials, and paste it. And based on the information, which are the materials that best suited for we use as visor for helmet. Okay, so you can search, you can just Google, example, open a browser. Okay. Oh, okay. I think I missed some information. Okay, for lab 2, I'll upload. I forgot, I know what I missed. I forgot to put, this is the last. I'll update now this my lab sheet here, and I'll upload it straight away today. And you learn, so you can. I want you to rank the students that are likely candidate for health advisor based on screening, ranking, and documentation, meaning that you've already done the screening, you got the seven materials, potential materials, and you rank them, and you find the information. So based on the information that you, all these three steps that you've gone through, choose three candidate materials and rank them between best to lowest. Okay. So I forgot to, I think yang group 2 pun dah already done this lab, but never mind. For group 1 here, then you have to, you need to do this. You have to find the information. Okay. I was interrupted. So, okay. So for example, we want to find information. Just as I said just now, just find the information online. So let's say we type in for borosilicate glass, that we find, okay. Just type here. Glass. Example, visor. Got the information that I want, sorry. Just general borosilicate glass. So you can, it doesn't matter you if you want to use Wikipedia. It's just that don't use exact word by word of Wikipedia, or find information word by word of Wikipedia. It's better if you find some information, for example, like this Science Direct. This is good. So you just copy the information. For example, borosilicate glass and the properties here, and just we can and then just paste result for. So type in, for example, borosilicate. Okay, just basically like that. So all seven materials, copy and paste. Okay, find the information, documentation, and then finally after that, write them. Okay, I want you to choose the three materials that are likely that can be used for helmet visor based on all this information that we done screening. Write them, okay, according to fracture toughness, and then based on the information that we searched online, so which are the materials that suitable. So you just put here rank the three best materials for helmet binder is Fr. One is what? Okay, X material, 2, 3 is X material. Okay, so do that. Okay, so then you can you already finished the lab, and then you can submit. Okay, so any question? Do you have any questions?
So yang 3 base of material tu based on yang kita dapat dari
ni, from the 7. Okay.
Daripada 7 ni base of 3 lah kita ambil.
Correct.
Okay. Alright. Okay.
Any other question?
So report ni individu or by group sir?
Individu.
Okay.
Okay, I want to ask who doesn't have access to PC, laptop ke anything? Anyone? Apa tu nampak tak dekat if you look at our interface of Microsoft Teams here. Okay. I'll stop sharing. Okay, first. You look there, besides participants, okay, you can have a chat, and also next there, you can have, we have the raise your hand. So dia akan keluar on the participants, it will come up. So does not have access to PC? Because it's important, when I will do, because some of the assessment, for example, lab test later on, you have the software to, as I mentioned in our second lab session, you have to have access to the software. You need to use it, okay, for the subject. And I think semua ada access PC, bukan guna. I think today most of you are using PC, not using handphone. If you're using handphone, no problem for the session, but for the works, actually you have to use your PC. Semua ada, I think.
Yang ni, lab ni hantar besok ni, sir.
Deadline saya letak. I put in ULearn, you can submit by tomorrow. If you want by today, I'll be shown the result. Yes.
Ada kawan saya dua orang tak dapat masuk. Sebab laptop hantar servis hari ni. So, diorang pun tak tahu dapat bila. Kalau sebuah deadline esok, tak tahulah diorang boleh buat kertas sebab diorang nak masuk Teams pun tak boleh hari ni.
Siapa?
Ain, dia ada hantar dekat grup WhatsApp.
Ain ni.
Ain dengan Alia tak silap saya tadi.
Mitri dia call and take ni. Okay. Ini Alia. I'm